Good afternoon. We will open with invocation, and then I will provide the welcome. Invocation by Dr. Cheryl Sanders.
Let us pray. Eternal God, it is with deep gratitude in our hearts that we have gathered in your name today. We thank you, God, for the opening convocation of this semester for the School of Divinity. And we praise you and thank you for all the blessings that you have bestowed upon us as members of a teaching and learning community. Thank you for Howard University, the legacy, the diversity, and thank you, God, for the future you have given this university with hope. We pray, oh God, that in this time of convocation, your anointing will be upon every word that is spoken or sung, that our gestures might point toward the direction in which you are leading and guiding us. May your anointing rest upon your servant who will bring an address to us today. Heighten our awareness, O God, we pray. Teach us reconciliation and civility and hope. This is our prayer in your name. Let all the people of God say, amen.
It is my privilege, as the Dean of the Howard University School of Divinity, on the occasion of our spring semester convocation being held in the historic Andrew Rankin Memorial Chapel, in this, the company of the Howard faithful, students, faculty, administrators, staff, alumni, and friends, to welcome you. Our presence here today as a community is fitting because we commemorate the Martin Luther King Jr. holiday and we honor his legacy of the beloved community, the just society, the care of persons, a more perfect union where equality and access are had by all. It is a signal honor to welcome you to the School of Divinity's spring convocation, and to welcome to our campus the United States Department of Health and Human Services Secretary, Kathleen Sebelius. At this time, I have asked the Provost of our university, Dr. James Weish, followed by the Senior Vice President for Health Sciences, Dr. Eve Higginbotham, to bring us very brief words of greeting. Dr. Weish and Dr. Higginbotham.
Thank you, Dean Pollard. When I woke up this morning, I was not sure that this event would take place, but I think someone else higher than me saw that it would occur. And I really am grateful to be here today. I certainly say good morning to you, good afternoon to you as well. I also say that this is a wonderful event that the School of Divinity puts on in its spring commencement. I bring you greetings from the President, Dr. Sidney Rabeau, Board of Trustees, faculty, students, alums of Howard University. I also want to say to you that as our great nation strives to present us national unity, it's at again a time of introspection. Let us reaffirm that we are one nation under God. We pray that Howard University can be an exemplar for the current and future leaders of our nation, but also conduct ourselves as a national exemplar for all of our global communities. I want to thank you for coming today, but also thank you for all that you mean, not only to Howard, our nation as well. Thank you very much for coming.
Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the faculty, staff, students, and our deans and senior leadership in the health sciences, we bring you greetings. I am so very honored to be with you today to embark on the spring semester in such a thoughtful way. Madam Secretary, I am particularly happy to see you as we celebrate the courage of this administration to put forward a health care reform act that really makes a difference in our nation and in particular communities of color. We know that we deal with health inequity across this country. We have come far too far, given we have gone far too long with issues of disparities that we have to deal with. There is no reason why every citizen in this country should have the right to health care. It's a bit ironic when you think about it that Congress is at this moment considering repealing this important law. However, because we're assembled today in a house of prayer, I know we will prevail. So thank you, Madam Secretary, for your courage and that of our dear President, President Obama. We welcome you here. We look forward to working with you in the health sciences, and we look forward to a brighter day for every citizen in this country where everyone has a right to health and wellness. Thank you.
At this time, we will have the recognition of the honoring of the ancestors, pouring of the libations.
Good afternoon. I am not the Reverend Dr. Harold Dean Trulier. I am Robin Franklin Vaughn. I am the chapel coordinator at the Howard University School of Divinity, and I'm joined by my friend and colleague, Ms. Claretta McDaniel, the assistant dean for student affairs at the School of Divinity. Now, it seems the weather has conspired to bring us some challenges, but we're people who know how to face challenges and prevail. So we pray for those who were not able to make it, and we thank God for those of you who have. We have already invoked the spirit of the divine. We will not neglect the spirit of our ancestors, on whose shoulders we stand, those who paved the way for each one of us to be here, those who worked tirelessly for human rights, civil rights, who worked in the sciences and in the arts. And so we pause to remember a few. We remember Martin Luther King Jr., Audre Geraldine Lord, Alhaj Malik Shabazz, known as Malcolm X, Nannie Helen Burroughs, Bayard Rustin, Ella Baker. You know, in the last book of the Christian canon, in the book of Revelations, in the last chapter, there's this beautiful image of a river flowing through the city and a tree that stretches on both sides of the river. And that tree bears 12 types of fruit, each in its season. And the leaves of that tree are given for the healing of the nation. And in my preacher's imagination, I closed my eyes and I saw a tree, a river that flowed through the city of Washington, D.C. It's an asphalt river. We call it Georgia Avenue. There's a tree that stands and spreads on either side of Georgia Avenue. It stretches from the West Campus of the Howard School of Law to Main Campus, Howard University, all the way over, Dean Pollard, to the beautiful rolling hills of the East Campus, the School of Divinity. That tree has produced some phenomenal leaves. They are our staff, our administrators, our faculty, our students, all who have gone out to bring healing to the world. For those leaves that have fallen, to replenish the soil that we stand in, we call their names. James Edward Cheek, Lawrence Neal Jones, Charles Drew, Kwame Ture, Naomi Brooks Wright. We indeed are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. I invite each and every one of you to call out the names of your mother, your father, your grandmother, your grandfather, those in your neighborhood, your community, on whose shoulders you stand. We thank them, we're proud of them, louder. Amen. Amen. And together we say, Amen, Ashe.
In the same manner that we do honor our tradition, our culture, our African descended legacy, through the recognition of those who have gone before, now also do we recognize and honor our sacred scripture, the Hebrew scriptures, followed by additional sacred texts, emblematic of those who are well-versed and read in the literature and traditions of peoples across our world. We will follow the program beginning with Dr. Nasha Jr.
The Hebrew Bible reading for today is from Proverbs chapter 3, 13 through 18, and I will be reading from the Hebrew. Ashrei Adam Matza Chokma, Va'adam Yafik Tuvuna. Kitov Saraha, Mitzhar Kasef. Ume Harutz Tuvuata. Yakara hi Mipninim Vokol Hafaseka Lo Yishvu Ba. Orek Yamim Bemina. Bish mola osher v'kavod. Darakeha darke noam v'kol nativoteha shalom. Etz chayim hi la mahazikim ba v'tomkeha meushar.
As you have just heard the reading of the Hebrew scripture in its original language, I'll read for you the same scripture, Proverbs 3, verses 13 through 18. It's a scripture that speaks to the essence of the true wealth. The word of the Lord reads, "Happy are those who find wisdom and those who get understanding, for income is better than silver and her revenue better than gold. She is more precious than jewels, and nothing you desire can compare with her. Long life is in her right hand, and in her left hand are riches and honor. Her ways are ways of pleasantness, and all her paths are peace. She is a tree of life to those who lay hold of her. Those who hold her fast are called happy." The word of the Lord.
I will be reading the sacred text from the Quran, from the book of Surah, chapter 5, verses 6 through 7 in English. Remember Allah's grace upon you and his covenant by which he bound you when you said, "We hear and we obey and keep your duty to Allah. Lo, Allah knoweth what is in the heart, the breasts of men. O ye who believe, be steadfast witnesses for Allah in equity. And let not hatred of any people seduce you that you not deal justly. Deal justly, that is nearer to your duty. Observe your duty to Allah. Lo, Allah is informed of what ye do."
And reading now from the Buddha's sermon at Benares, from the Asva Gosha and the Fosho Hing San King. To keep the body in good health is a duty, for otherwise we shall not be able to trim the lamp of wisdom and keep our minds strong and clear. The spokes of the wheel are the rules of pure conduct. Justice is uniformity of their length. Wisdom is the tire. Modesty and thoughtfulness are the hub in which the immovable axle of truth is fixed. He who recognizes the existence of suffering, its cause, its remedy, and its cessation, has fathomed the four noble truths. He will walk in the right path. Amen.
There are a number of persons who we would like to acknowledge who are here today. For the sake of time, I'm simply going to indicate that they are administrators, deans, academic leadership from numerous of our colleges and schools here at the university, from arts and sciences, pharmacy, nursing and allied health, engineering, medicine, the office of the president, of course, the office of the provost, and the office of the senior vice president for health